Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Let me introduce myself. My name is Sheikh Nusrat Farhin. I am studying in 4th standard in Mahmood Islamic English Medium School. Today, I would like to tell about the night of power, Laylatul Qadr. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Inna azalnahu fi Laylatul Qadr. Wa ma adraka ma Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadri khairun min alfi shahr. تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. Ramzan in its entirety is an especially prominent time in Islam. Although there is one evening that is particularly meaningful, and that evening is Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadr, otherwise known as the night of power, and to be the considered by the Islamic calendars holiest eve. First verses to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look for it in the odd nights of the last 10 nights of the month Ramzan. The night of power is no longer or shorter than any other nights. We should have to complete our goodies on Laylatul Qadr. When we complete our goodies on Laylatul Qadr, your fasting is increased in reward one night. At the end, I pray to Allah, may Allah guide us straight path and extend our taqwa. Ameen, summa ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
MashaAllah, wonderful speech. Let me invite
all of you with Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Let me introduce myself. My name is Jasmir. I am studying 4th standard in Mahmood Islamic English Medium School. Nahmaduhu wa nusalli ala rasulihi al-kareem. Amma abad. Today I would like to tell about obedience to parents and its limits. The parent and child relationship is the pillar of family life and the basic building block of civilization. Islam teaches to cultivate positive, healthy and functional relation between parents and their children. Part of this imperative is to balance the rights and duty of both parents and children. Children have the duty to support their parents all of their reasonable request, while parents need to give children room to grow and to develop their unique personalities. Allah said, وَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Worship Allah, associate nothing with Him, and be good to your parents. Indeed, disobedience to parents is considered one of the major sins. In every circumstance, it is not permissible to obey one's parents if they command us to do something sinful. Ali رضي الله عنه reported, the Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him, said, لا تأتى في المعصية إنما الطاعة في المعروف. There is no obedience to anyone if it is disobedience to Allah. Verify obedience is only in good conduct. The standard of obedience is good conduct, that which lawful, reasonable and good. The principle is true to any relationship. It is not allowed for a Muslim to obey anyone, your parents, your teachers, your imam, your political leader, if it is involved to sinning against Allah or His creation. Success comes from Allah and Allah knows best. At the end, I pray to Allah, may Allah guide us all to respect and value our parents and to follow Sahih Hadith and become an obedient child. Jazakallahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa nusalli ala rasulil kareem. Amma abad. Respected chief guest, director sir, teachers, parents and my dear friends, I welcome all of you with the Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today I would like to tell about the seven major sins in Islam. The seven major destructive sins in Islam. Do you know the seven? said, avoid the seven sins that doom one to hell. Associating others with Allah is called shirk. Magic killing a soul whom Allah has forbidden killing. Consuming interest is called riba. Consuming the property of our friends. Fleeing on the day of the march to be battlefield. Slandering chaste women. Associating others with Allah is called shirk. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it is hoped that Allah may forgive every sin except in the case of one who a polytheist. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Inna Allah la yaghfir an yushraka bih wa yaghfir ma duna zalika liman yasha. Indeed, Allah does not forgive association with Him, but He forgive what is less than that for whom He wills. At the end, I pray to Allah, may Allah protect us all from this major sins. Ameen. Jazakallahu khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Associating others with
often who a politics. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Inna Allah la yaghfir an yushraka bi wa yaghfir ma dun zalika liman yasha. Indeed, Allah does not forgive association with him, but he forgives what is less than that for whom he wills. At the end, I pray to Allah, May Allah protect us all from this major sins. Ameen. Jazakallahu khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa nusalli ala rasulil kareem. Amma abad. Respected chief guest, director sir, teachers, parents and all my dear friends. I welcome all of you with the Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today, I would like to tell about the seven major sins in Islam. The seven major disrupt you sins in Islam. Do you know the seven major sins in Islam? Every Muslim must know and avoid these major sins to protect themselves from severe punishment. If you have ever committed any of these major sins in the past, repent sincerely to Allah and resolve to never return to it. It was narrated by Abu Huraira رضي الله تعالى عنه that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, avoid these seven sins that do one to hell. First one is associating others with Allah is called shirk. Second one is magic. Third one is killing a soul whom Allah has forbidden killing. Fourth one is consuming interest is called riba. Fifth one is consuming the property of organs. Sixth one is feeling on the day of the march. And the last one is slandering chaste women. Associating others with Allah is called shirk. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it is hoped that Allah may forgive every sin except in the case of one who a politics. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Inna Allah la yaghfir an yushraka bi wa yaghfir ma dun zalika liman yasha. Indeed, Allah does not forgive associations with him, but he forgives what is less than from whom he wills. And I pray to Allah, may Allah protect us to all of you seven sins. Amin, summa amin. Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi barakatuh.
نحمد وصلي على رسول الكريم اما بعد آج اس محفل میں میرا موضوع ہے حصول علم کی اہمیت اللہ رب العالمین کا ارشاد ہے کل هل يستوي الذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون انما يتذكر اولو الالباب بدلاؤ تو بھلا علم والے اور بے علم والے کیا برابر ہے یقیناً نصیحت وہی حاصل کرتا ہے جو عقل مند ہے رسول صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے فرمایا طلب العلم فریضۃ علی کل مسلم علم کا حاصل کرنا ہر مسلمان پر فرض ہے مسلمانوں کو علم کی طرف سب سے زیادہ توجہ دینی چاہیے حصول علم کے لیے عمر بھر کے لیے قید نہیں ہے آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے ماں کی گود سے قبر میں اترنے تک علم حاصل کرنے کی ہدایت فرمائی اور قرآن کی سب سے پہلے وہی بھی علم کے بارے میں نازل ہوئی اقرأ بسم ربک الذی خلق پڑھو اپنے رب کے نام سے جس نے تمہیں پیدا کیا محترم سامعین و سامعات اللہ تعالیٰ نے انسان پر بے شمار احسانات کیے ان میں سے ایک بہت بڑا احسان یہ ہے کہ اللہ تعالیٰ نے انسان کو علم عطا کیا ہے جس کا ذکر سورۃ الالف کی آیت نمبر 5 میں کیا گیا ہے علم انسان کے لیے اللہ تعالیٰ کی ایسی نعمت ہے جو اسے باقی تمام مخلوقات سے ممتاز کرتی ہے ابو درد رضی اللہ عنہ نے रसूल सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम को फरमाते हुए सुना, जो हुसूल इल्म के लिए किसी रास्ते पर चलता है तो अल्लाह ताला उसकी वजह से उसको जन्नत के रास्तों में से एक रास्ते पर चलाता है, और फरिश्ते तालिबे इल्म की रजा के लिए उसके नीचे पर बिछाते हैं, और बेशक जमीन व आसमान की तमाम मखलूक और पानी में मछलियाँ आलिम के लिए बख्शिश की दुआ करते हैं, और आलिम के आबिद पर ऐसी फजीलत है जो से चौदहवीं रात के चांद को बाकी सितारों पर है, और इसी इल्म के जरिए अल्लाह ताला ने इंसान को फरिश्तों पर फजीलत दी है। यरफ़ाउल्लाहु अल्लज़ीना आमनु मिनकुम वल्लज़ीना ऊतिल इल्मा दरजात। अल्लाह ताला ने फरमाया, अल्लाह तुम में से उन लोगों को जो ईमान लाए हैं और जो इल्म दिए गए हैं दर्जे बुलंद कर देगा। आखिर में अल्लाह ताला से दुआ है कि अल्लाह हम सबको इल्म दीन हासिल करने और उस पर अमल करने की तौफीक अता फरमाए। आमीन सुम्मा आमीन। अस्सलाम वालेकुम
व नसल्ली अला रसूलिल करीम। अम्मा बाद, हॉनरेबल चीफ गेस्ट, रेस्पेक्टेड डायरेक्टर सर, टीचर्स, पेरेंट्स, माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू विद द इस्लामिक ग्रीटिंग्स। अस्सलाम वालेकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातहू। लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस माय सेल्फ, माय नेम इज वारिस खान, आई एम स्टडीइंग फोर्थ स्टैंडर्ड इन महमूद इस्लामिक इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्पीक अबाउट सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस। अल्लाह सुब्हानहु व तआला से इन होली कुरान, वलैसा लिल इंसान इल्ला मा सा, एंड दैट मैन कैन हैव नथिंग बट व्हाट ही डज। वी ऑल नो दैट सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस मींस हैविंग ए बिलीव इन योरसेल्फ एंड योर एबिलिटीज। इट इज फ्रीडम फॉर डाउट्स। इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ए हेल्थी एंड पॉजिटिव लाइफस्टाइल विद सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस। नो वन कैन अचीव देयर गोल्स ऑफ गॉड माइंड बट यू मेक सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस। सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस मेक ए पर्सन इंडिपेंडेंट, एंगर, ऑप्टिमिस्टिक एंड ऑल दिस कैरेक्टरिस्टिक टू अचीव गोल्स इन लाइफ। Self-confidence is a key of success, plays a significant role in life. You must practice acquiring self-confidence and become a successful person in life. If you are self-confident, there are more chances to success in life. Remember, self-confidence cannot be built in a day. It takes time, so keep working on your work. Achieve your goals slowly. Jazakallahu khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
to the family and life of these children. And that I pray to Allah, may Allah guide us to the straight path and to follow Sunnah. Tazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi.